Hello everyone, in the last lecture we have completed 1.2 the thief story from first unit. We have discussed all activities and also grammar questions. Today I am starting 1.5 Joan of Arc. Joan is a name of one courageous girl. We can take this title as a heroine of France, and this is a story of a brave, a courageous girl named Joan. This topic has been written by the famous writer George Bernard Shaw, and this is a play. First of all, let's learn about this author, George Bernard Shaw. He was born in 1856 and he had been passed in 1950. Such George Bernard Shaw was an Irish playwright and critic. He was a playwright, also critic. He wrote more than 60 plays during his lifetime, including major works such as Man and Superman in 1902, Pygmalion in 1912, and Saint Joan in 1923. Look, George Bernard Shaw was the greatest playwright, and he had written more than 60 plays during his lifetime, and his work included major works such as Man and Superman, Pygmalion, and Saint Joan. He was leading dramatist of his time. He was the leading dramatist of his time. Means he has written many dramas also. So he has been considered as the leading dramatist in his time. He was awarded the Nobel Prize in Literature in 1925. He has been awarded with the greatest award, Nobel Prize, for his greatest contribution in literature in 1925. Such greatest author, George Bernard Shaw, has written this lesson, Joan of Arc. It's a play, so let's start this topic. This topic is about one courageous girl, very ambitious girl named Joan. I start this lesson, pay attention. The war fought between England and France from 1337 to 1453 has come to be known as 100 years war. Look, there was one war which has been known as the 100 years war. Why? Because that war was between England and France. That war was between England and France, and it has been started in 1337 and ended in 1453. 100 years that war between England and France had been continued, so that war has been considered as the 100 years war. Joan was a peasant girl, peasant village girl. Peasant girl means a poor village girl born in eastern France who led the French army to several victories during this war. Joan was a peasant girl, one poor farmer's girl who was born in Eastern Europe, and such brave Joan contributed, helped French army in several victories during this war. It means Joan, a courageous girl who was a peasant girl and born in Eastern France, had led the French army to several victories during this war. This play begins at the time when all northern France and some parts of the southwest were under foreign control. Look, when did this play start? This play begins at a time when all of northern France and some parts of the southwest were under foreign control. This play has been begun when all the northern part of France and some parts of the southwest were under foreign control, means Britishers had controlled over all northern and some parts of southwest. The English controlled some parts and Burgundians controlled others. Burgundy is a region of France. No doubt, Burgundy is one city in the France, and Burgundians means native people living in Burgundy. The English controlled some parts, whereas the Burgundians controlled others. The Britishers had controlled some parts, whereas the old people in France, Burgundians, had controlled the other part. The city of New Orleans, one of the few remaining French cities, was held by English. Look what happened. The city of New Orleans, one of the few remaining French cities, was also captured and controlled by Britishers. And the year is 1429 when this play begins. This year is 1429, means at that time the year was 1429. Captain Robert D. Bordicourt, a military officer, is seated at a table. His steward means assistant, male attendant. Steward, you know, male attendant or assistant, facing him. And look, what is the scene of this play? Captain Robert D. Bordicourt, who is a military officer, is seated near the table and his assistant is in front of him. And from that scene, this play has been begun. Look, I will tell again in short. There was war between England and France, and that war has been started in 1337 and has been ended in 1453. That war has been continued nearly about 100 years. So this war has been known as the Hundred Years' War. Britishers had controlled some parts in France. There was one captain who is chief of the that France, namely Robert D. Baudricourt, who is a military officer. And when this scene started at that time, that military officer and his male attendant was there, and they are speaking with each other, they are communicating with each other about something. Look what Robert says to Steward. I told you to throw the gun out. Robert got angry due to that girl. He asked Steward that he had told him to throw that girl out. Robert told Steward that he had warned him to throw that girl out. You have 50 armed soldiers and dozens of strong servants to carry out my orders. Are they afraid of her? Robert made Steward to remember that he had 50 armed soldiers and dozens of strong servants to carry out his orders. So he asked Steward whether they had been afraid of that girl. Robert was speaking about that girl. He was so angry on that girl. He asked Robert, he had told him to throw that girl out, and he made him remember by telling him that he had 50 armed soldiers, dozens of strong servants to carry his orders. Whether they all had been afraid of that girl? Look, what did Steward reply? Steward, no sir, we are afraid of you, but she puts courage in us. Steward frankly replied that no one had been afraid of that girl. Actually, they had been afraid of Robert. They were getting afraid to that Robert. That girl inspires all of them. According to Steward, Steward says that no one is afraid to that girl. Instead, that girl, inspires everyone. She really doesn't seem to be afraid of anything. Steward also told about that girl that actually she is not afraid of anything. She doesn't seem to be afraid of anything. Perhaps you could frighten her, sir. And Steward thought that Robert would frighten that girl. Now look, Robert grimly, seriously. Perhaps, where is she now? Now Robert spoke seriously. Perhaps he would frighten her. And he asked Steward where the girl was. Now look, Steward, down in the courtyard, sir. Steward informed Robert that girl had been in the courtyard. Robert goes to the window and asks the soldiers to send the girl up. At that time, Robert went to the window and asked the soldiers to send that girl up. That girl enters. She is a well-built, strong country girl of 17 to 18 years. Then that girl entered. When the Robert called her, look how is that girl she is a well built strong country girl of 17 to 18 years. The squire's glare means look, neither frightens her nor stops her. As soon as she entered, at that time the squire looked at her a bit angrily, but that angry look neither frightened her neither stopped her. But that angry look neither frightened her nor stopped her. She started to speak confidently with Stewart. Stewart had thought that girl would afraid to him. That girl would feel awkward in front of Stewart, but actually that girl started speaking confidently in front of Robert. She does not afraid to him. Now Joan started to speak. The name of that girl is Joan. Good morning, Captain Squire. As soon as she entered, she greeted Robert by telling good morning. You are to give me a horse and armor and some soldiers and send me to the Dauphin. Look, Dauphin is the name of the oldest son of the King of France, the one who would become the king after his father. Dauphin is the name of the oldest son of the King of the France who would become king after his father's death. With heredity, he would become the king. And so look, as soon as John entered, he made Robert to remember that he had told her that he would give her a horse, armor, some soldiers, and also he wanted to send her to the Dauphin. Once Robert had promised her that he would give her a horse, armor and some soldiers, and he also promised her for sending to the Dauphin. After that, look, when John asked her about his promises, at that time, what did Robert reply? This girl is mad. He again got so angry. After listening John, Robert again got so angry and he called that girl mad. Why didn't you tell me so, you blockhead? Blockhead means stupid person. Blockhead means stupid person. He got again angry on Stewart. He thought this girl is very mad, and he asked Stewart why he hadn't told him about that stupid girl, about that foolish girl. Now look, Stewart says, sir, do not anger her, give her what she wants. Stewart requested Robert not to get angry on her, and he again requested Robert to give her what she wanted. Because Stewart was sure about that girl. Stewart was confident about that girl's courage, girl's strong willpower. Now look, Robert says, I shall send you back to your father with orders to put you under lock and key. But Robert was not ready to listen to Stewart. He was firm on his decision. He told Joan that he would send her back to her father with orders to put her under lock and key. Robert treated that girl by ordering her that he would send her to her father with orders to put in lock. Now June means Robert was trying to threaten that girl so that she would go, she would return to her house and she would not demand those things again. But John was really so confident. John didn't afraid to that threatening. What did she reply? Look, you think you win, squire, but it won't happen that way. John said confidently, Robert thinks that Robert will do anything, but according to her, such things won't happen in that way. Whatever he says, he doesn't do according to that show. You said you would not see me, but here I am. Once he had told that he would never see John, but again she would there at that time. It means whatever Robert says, he doesn't do that thing. He doesn't do that thing. And he remembered him that fact, that thing, once he had told that he would never look the face of her, but on that day she was again there. So whatever he says, whatever he orders, he never behaved with such orders. Now look, Robert, so you are assuming that I shall give you what you want? And Robert asked, it means she is thinking that he should give her what she wanted. Yes, squire, continuous, busily means very actively. Joan was much confident. She again excitedly, actively replied, yes, squire, a horse will cost 16 francs. Franc is the currency of France. Franc is a currency of franc. A horse will cost 16 francs. It is a big amount of money. She told Robert that a horse would cost 16 francs and it is a big amount, but I can save it on the armor. Joan is really thoughtful. She told him that she wanted horse and the cost of horse was 16 francs, but she was ready to save that money on armor. She needed armor also, but she is going to save the money of armor on that horse. I don't need beautiful armor made to my measure. She told Robert that she doesn't need new armor made to her measure. I can find a soldier's armor that will fit me well enough. Joan promised that she could find any other soldier's armor that will fit her well. I shall not want many soldiers. Joan again informed Robert that she wouldn't want many soldiers. There is no need to give her many soldiers. Dauphin will give me all I need to free Orleans. Look, what was her intention? She wanted to free Orleans city, which had been under the Britishers. So she wanted permission of Robert. She did not want many soldiers. She just want a horse. She would take armor of any other soldier that money would save on that horse. If she needed anything, then the Dauphin would give those things. And finally, Joan declared that she wanted to free Orleans. She wanted to free Orleans. When Robert listened, he got shocked. To free Orleans, in shocking state of mind, he again exclaimed, "To free Orleans?" Joan wanted to free Orleans. Joan simply, "Yes, why? 3 men will be enough for you to send with me." Joan was much confident to free Orleans. She simply told him, "Yes, sir, I wanted to free Orleans." Further, she told Robert that he can give her only 3 men. Polly and Jack have promised to come with me. She informed Robert that Polly and Jack had promised her to come with her. Only 3 men were enough to come with her. And already Polly and Jack had promised her to come with her. She informed Robert. "Robert, you mean Monsieur de Ponzi?" Monsieur means French word for Mr. Okay. Robert again confirmed by asking whether she means Mr. de Ponzi. "Monsieur de Ponzi?" Joan, "Yes, Squire Jack will come willingly." Joan agreed with Ponzi, and she also informed Robert that Squire Jack is also ready to come with her willingly. "He is a very kind gentleman and gives me money to give to the poor." Joan told about that Jack. According to her, "He is a very kind gentleman and he gives him money to give to the poor." I think John Godsey will come, Dick the archer and their servants, John of Honeycourt and Julian. Look, there are many officers to come with her, and she is informing Robert that John Godsey, Dick the archer, their servants, John of Honeycourt and Julian, all these people were ready to come with her to free Orleans. It means, except Robert, many officers were confident about Joan. Many officers were sure about Joan's performance, Joan's strong willpower. "There will be no trouble for you, Squire." After informing about those people, she again informed him that there would not be any trouble, there could not be any stress for him. "I have arranged it all," and she informed that she had arranged everything. "You have only to give the order." Okay, pay attention. Joan just wanted permission from Robert, as she had prepared everything. Some officers were ready to come with her, and Dauphin also promised to give her what she needed. But as a chief of that country, Joan had gone there to take permission from Robert. She wanted to free Orleans. Orleans is one of the remaining cities in the France which had been under the Britishers, and Joan wanted to free Orleans. Now, after listening Joan, Robert asked to the steward, "Is this true about Monsieur de Ponzi?" Robert asked the steward in shocked state of mind whether all that was true about Monsieur de Ponzi, because Robert was not sure about Ponzi, he would also go with her. So he asked steward again about Ponzi. Really, he was going with her? Steward eagerly, "Yes, sir, about Monsieur de Mainz too." Steward agreed with Ponzi, and he also told that Mr. de Mainz also agreed to go with her. They both want to go with her. Steward informed Robert that they both wanted to go with her. Now, Robert goes to the window and shouts into the courtyard. Then Robert went to the again window and shouted into the courtyard, "Saint Monsieur de Ponzi, Saint Monsieur Ponzi to me, will you?" Robert went to the window and he called his soldiers to send Monsieur de Ponzi to him. Then he turned to Joan, "Get out and wait in the yard." He warned Joan to get outside and she should wait in the yard. Joan, smiling brightly at him, "Right, squire," she goes out. Joan was in excited mood. With smiling, she went out. Robert, to the steward, "Go with her." Robert advised the steward, "Stay within call and keep your eye on her." He warned steward to keep his eye on her. "I shall have her up here again." Robert told steward to go with her, to keep his eye on her, because he wanted that Joan again there after some time. Then the steward retreats hastily, look the meaning, moves away in a hurry. Then the steward moves away in a hurry. Bertrand de Ponzi, a French guard, entered, salutes, stands waiting. At that time, Bertrand de Ponzi, who is a French guard, entered, saluted, and stood in front of Robert. Then Robert started communicating with Ponzi. "She says you, Jack, and Dick have offered to go with her." "What for?" Robert asked Ponzi that Joan was saying him that. Ponzi, Jack, and Dick had promised to go with her. After asking that, Robert asked, "For which reason?"
they had been going with her.
Do you take her crazy idea of going to the Dolphin seriously? Robert asked Ponzi whether all of them had taken her stupid idea of going to Dolphin seriously. Robert was not sure. Robert was not confident about that show. He was having doubt on her. He was feeling that a girl like Joan cannot do anything in the war, and to free Orlene was another story. But except Robert, others were much confident on Joan. So Robert suspiciously asked whether all of them had taken her stupid idea of going to Dolphin seriously. Then look, what did Ponzi reply? Slowly, there is something about her. Ponzi was also sure about that girl. He told Robert, sir, there is something about her. It may be worth trying. They should try with that permission. It means Ponzi also was with that girl, and according to Ponzi, Robert must give permission to that girl. There might be worth trying. Now when Robert listened Ponzi, oh come on Polly, you must be out of your mind. After Ponzi also, Robert was not ready to give his permission. He told Ponzi he must be out of his mind. His mental health is not good. How can he think in that way? Means Robert also did not trust that Ponzi. He called him stupid. He called him mental ill person. Now Ponzi unmoved means determined. What is wrong with it? Ponzi was firm on his decision. Ponzi was firm on his decision. So he asked what was wrong with it. What was wrong with it? The dolphin is in Chinon like a rat in a corner. Chinon is a place, one of the cities in France where royal family resided. During the 100 years war, the dolphin took refuge. Refuge means shelter in Chinon. Ponzi asked Robert about his son Chinon. The dolphin is in Chinon like a rat in a corner. Except that he won't fight. Ponzi remembered Robert. The dolphin is in Chinon as like a rat in corner. Except he wouldn't fight. The English will take Orleans. According to Ponzi, if such thing continued, then the Britishers would also take Orleans. He shall not be able to stop them. According to Ponzi, dolphin cannot do anything to save Orleans because he has been in Chinon as like a rat in a corner and he won't fight. Ponzi told this ability of dolphin and he was sure that Joan would do something. Now look on that. What did Robert reply? He beat the English the year before last at Montargis. Montague Place I was with him. At that time, Robert took side of Duffy. Robert informed Ponzi that Duffy had defeated the Englishman in the last year and he was with him. According to Robert, he had witnessed that war and Duffy had beat the English the year before last at Montargis. So according to Robert, Duffy is not a coward man. Just 1 minute. Okay, look what happened. But Robert was not ready to listen Ponzi about Duffy. He was sure about Duffy, about his courage, about his hard work. According to him, he had defeated the Englishman in the last year as Robert was with him. Now look on that statement, what did Ponzi reply? But his men are cowed. Cowed means frightened, and now he can't work miracles. Ponzi replied that the soldiers of Duffy were so frightened and now Duffy can't work any miracle. Duffy can't do any kind of miracle. And I tell you that nothing can save our side now but a miracle. According to Ponzi, nothing can save their side but miracle can save their side. Robert, look what did Robert reply on miracles. Miracles are all right, Polly. The only difficulty about them is that they don't happen nowadays. Robert replied about miracles that miracles were all right. But according to him, the only difficulty about them that they had been not happening in those days. Ponzi told Robert that only miracles can save them. But according to Robert, miracles had been not happening in those days. Now Ponzi replied, I used to think so. Ponzi was also thinking same. I'm not so sure now. And Ponzi was not sure at that time also about miracles. But there is something about her. But Ponzi was sure about that Joe. According to him, there was something about her. I think the girl herself is a bit of miracle. According to Ponzi, that Joan was herself a bit of miracle. Anyhow, this is our last chance. Let's see what she can do. Ponzi remembered Robert that was the last chance, and so they should see what Joan can do. According to Ponzi, Robert must give permission to Joan. Because all kinds of efforts have been done, all kinds of methods have been used to free Orleans, but they did not get success. So Ponzi thought that Robert should give one chance to that Joan to free Orleans, as there was something about that girl. Robert was not mentally ready. Wavering means hesitating. You really think that? Robert, in a confused state, asked whether Ponzi really thinks. Ponzi, is there anything else left for us to think? Ponzi again asked if there was anything left to think. Let's take a chance. According to Kunsi, they should take chance. Her words have put fire into me. Kunsi told Robert that her words had inspired him. Her words had inspired everyone. Every French soldier. So according to Kunsi, they should give an opportunity to that zone. So Kunsi told Robert to give permission. Robert giving up. Viv, you are as mad as she is. It Robert called Kunsi mad as like Joan. He was not ready to give permission to Joan to free Orleans, as he was not confident, he was not sure about Joan. Now Kunsi obstinately, in a stubborn and firm manner, Kunsi, we want a few mad people now. Kunsi told Robert that at that time some mad people were needed. See where the same ones have landed us. The same ones. There should be same ones, not same ones. Kunsi told that they needed some few people because according to him, some clever, some sane people have taken in that situation. Means he commented that Dauphin indirectly. Robert, I feel like a fool still if you feel sure. Robert replied that he has been feeling as like a fool to give permission to Joan. Still, if Kunsi is sure, then he would ready. It means, lastly, he was getting ready. He was getting ready to give permission. Kunsi, I feel sure enough to take her to Chinon unless you stop me. Kunsi replied that if Robert did not stop him, then he would take her to Chinon. Then he would take her to Chinon, and Kunsi is sure about that. Robert, do you think I ought to have another talk with her? Robert asked Kunsi if he thinks that he should have another talk with her. If he should to have another talk with her. Look. Kunsi asked Robert whether he thinks that Robert should speak Joan again regarding that, or regarding that permission. Kunsi realized that Robert is getting ready to give her permission. So going to window, yes, Joan, come up. Then Kunsi went to the window and he called Joan. Joan entered. Kunsi gravely beseated Joan. Kunsi told Joan to sit down there. Robert, what is your name? Then Robert asked Joan her name. Joan replied, they always call me Janine Laurie. Joan replied that people always called her Jenny in the lorry. Here in France, I am Joan. Joan replied that, but in the France, she is being called Joan. The soldiers call me the maid. She again told that the soldiers call her the maid. How old are you? Then Robert asked her age. Joan replied, 17, so they tell me. People tell her that she is 17 years old. It might be 19. But according to her, she might be 19. She don't remember. She really doesn't remember. I don't remember. She really doesn't remember. her age, she might be 17 or 19. Okay, now time is over. I stop here. What happened? Whether the Robert has given the permission to Joan or not, we shall see in the next lecture. I stop here. Thank you very much.